be right now.
So, Coach, what's your prediction?
Pain.
Does it go all, what is it, three rounds, five rounds?
It's a three-round fight.
Does it go all three rounds?
I think Tito's going to put him out of there. That's his goal.
First round.
I like first better.
Makes it an easy night for all of us.
Camp's been good?
I'm telling you. Very good. I mean, what am I going to say? No. But at the end of the day, it is. I mean, it's the best I've seen him. I mean, even at 43 years old, for God's sakes. Now, he's getting better with age.
Now, Chris is getting ready for a major fight.
Huh?
Chris Cybord is getting ready for a major. How's she
doing? Oh, big fight. Big fight. Major
Amanda
fight.
Nunes.
Amanda Nunes. Two champs going at it. Yep. It's a big one, man. That's going to be December 29th. I expect stoppage in the first round, that one. Too.
I agree with you.
What's up, Rob?
First round.
Hi, how are you, hon?
Good.
Nice to see
you.
Yeah, you too.
Everybody's
supposed to be an embargo.
So what else is new, Coach? How's life?
Life is amazing. I got RDA fighting actually a week after Tito's fight as well. So I've been busy. At the end of the year right now, it's real busy. I got three big fights. And then life's going to be nice and relaxed. I'm going to go on a little vacation. It's been a while.
It seems like it's either feast or famine. It's either crazy busy or just
that's
slow.
That's it, yeah. Which is kind of nice. It's better than always. Well, yeah, I guess you want to always be busy, but in all honesty, I've been doing this so long, you get burned out a little bit. You know what I mean? You put a lot of your energy into these guys and a lot of your soul in these guys, and it sucks you dry sometimes, man. But I have a nice relaxing vacation after all these fights.
Let me introduce you. This is Andrew with TMZ.
How you doing, man?
How you doing?
He's a good dude.
Jason, no, I follow
him. Okay.
Oh, okay, he knows who you are.
Boxing coach. This being Cyborg, Tito, RVCA. This guy's a legend.
Hey.
Thank you.
You know, I want to set up a wrestling match with him and Logan Paul. What do you think? Who would win?
Well, I don't know either one of them really, not that well, do I?
Well, Logan Paul is the YouTuber, the talker.
Okay, yeah.
And he was a college wrestler, so...
Did this Logan Paul, was he a competitive athlete as well?
Yeah, All-American wrestler too.
Oh, well, All-American, you were college. Junior college.
Oh, sure.
It's tough, man. What's the weight on old Logan Paul?
Logan weighs like 200 right now. I weigh 300. But I'll cut down to 250 and wrestle.
So you guys meet at 250? Yeah. I'll pay to watch it.
I was a 197 pounder.
I was gonna ask you if you could train him, but okay.
His hands.
Yeah. Well, we'll have Tito work with him.
Tito's a good wrestler, right?
He's a good wrestling coach as well.
That'd be sick.
Yeah.
No one wants to see this content.
You never know.
But what makes you unique? You're big into boxing. A lot of MMA coaches don't come from a boxing background.
A lot of them, because you know. You can use all the tools in MMA with kick into the punch, into the knees and the elbows and whatnot. I mean, I understand that idea of fighting as well, but for me, I've been able to work up the ladders with a lot of high-level athletes, just strictly being, you know, my specialty being boxing, but I'm also a coach as well. I jump up inside this bad boy. You know, and plus at the end of the day, the movement of boxing, I think, is much more fitting for fighting than MMA fighting than...
Who's your favorite boxer in the world today? Who do you enjoy the most?
Muay Thai.
It's working.
It's tough to say. You know, I mean, you look at a guy like Lomachenko, who is just slick as snot, man. The guy is poetry in motion. And, I guess that's a guy that I would look at, and to be real honest, I really drifted off the map as far as boxing, as far as following boxing. You know, I never really made it to the highest echelon of coaching in the game of boxing, but I've lost my fan base. I don't know all the fighters. I don't know who everybody is. I mean, I know Crawford out there. He's amazing. It is a guy. You know, the biggest names out there, obviously. Mikey Garcia as well. Yeah, of course.
Canelo,
of course. Yeah, Canelo I like a lot. Yeah, I think that kid's stuck. He's been around for a long time. Yeah. You know, if they're good, I'll watch them, man.
Okay. How's Tito's boxing? We all know his wrestling. We all know his ground game is amazing. Does he have hands?
You know what? He's got a he's got tremendous power. He's coming to his own with it as far as his balance. You know, he's such a strict wrestler. You know, he's always about double leg, putting you on your back, and elbowing. You know, so you know, developing his balance and getting him a little more fluid, a little more snap on the shots. You know, the guy can punch. You know, and I expect him to put his hands on Chuck.
I know you only train superstars. You only train big names.
That's not necessarily true. I do train other, like, low names guys too. But
okay, what I'm trying to get at, maybe I misunderstood. If someone just starting MMA and they walk into your gym, what advice would you give to beginners?
As far as what
to do, what not to do, first day in a gym.
Well, I mean, you gotta learn to fucking stand up, really, at first, right? You know, doing this for a long time and working with high level athletes as well. It's a difficult conversation for me sometimes, and also I gotta be very patient. But the other day, brand new guys, like I have a kid that just got out of the Marine Corps, then hit me up on Instagram, hit me up on social media, hey, I want to come train, I want to be a fighter, you know. I opened the door to him, came in, you know. What I did with him, because he's a tough kid, and he really wanted to be a fighter. If you want to be a fighter, I put him in the first week, you know. Showed him a little stance, showed him to throw some punches, said, okay, you're going to throw punches at another guy. And I'll have him there with a pro that is just going to
work with him,
you know what I mean? And find out if this is something they want to do, you know, because it's a long, long life being a fighter, man. And it's not for everybody. It's something you want to do. And it's a guy walking on the street saying, I want to be a fighter. I really test him right off the bat. Hey, do you really want to be a fighter? Let's find out. And that's how I found out, you know what I mean? And
it's a big commitment, and it's 24/7, 365.
Yeah.
It's not part-time.
They keep coming back. This kid keeps coming back, by the way. He's been coming back for the last 4 months.
Hopefully he's your next champion.
And he was in there. He got picked up over the course of time because he's a big, strong kid. But, hey, you know, you never know who's going to stay and who's going to go.
So, Gojo, all that talk of Mayweather fighting a kickboxer, what did you make of that?
It just came out of nowhere now, didn't it? So it's hard to even think about it because it came and left just like that. Boom. And I think it was obviously for me it was the promotion Risen. I believe it's Risen. I think they wanted to draw some attraction towards one of their uprising stars and also
Pension.
And their promotion itself. So yeah, I'm just curious how much they paid Floyd to go along with it for a week or whatever it was, a few days, you know. It had to be pretty good money. I don't know. But
So December 29th, Chris Cyborg, Amanda Nunes, the fight is where?
Las Vegas.
Big fight, because they were talking about Brazil a year ago, but now it's Vegas.
Yeah.
It's the fight of the year. Everyone's excited. Chris is the best pound-for-pound champion in the UFC. Nunes the champ. Do you think she makes it to fight night? Because a couple times she couldn't make weight.
Well, that's a question that we're training as if she's going to be there. It'd be nice to know if there's other options if she doesn't make it. But we're hoping, you know, we're hoping to be there. And I know Chris got it into her head a little bit at the media conference to let her know, hey, I know you don't show up, you know, and she put it in her face. So, you know, it's on her. She's got to stay healthy and make it there. We got to make it there as well. You know, this MMA game, think about boxing. You don't see a lot of guys pulling out for injuries on boxing. You want to know why? Because they're just upstairs cracking each other in the face. You know, that beats these MMA guys up. It's a lot of the grappling and the you know, the takedowns. And you got joints, you got knees, you got ankles, you got elbows. You got a lot of those type of injuries that takes guys out of the fights.
Pantera Rodriguez got that elbow. That was crazy.
Right? Okay, yeah.
Came out of nowhere with one.
Over that
I've
way,
never
huh?
seen that.
Yeah, well, I don't know if he even meant to do it.
So, if Cyborg's the best female pound-for-pound champ, who's on the male side? Who's the best fighter in the world right now?
I'd have to say DC, really. I would have to say DC. He is, and he's holding two titles in two weight classes, and he fights nothing but beasts. So you got to give DC credit where credit's due.
Okay, John Jones, how are they doing the rematch with Gustafsson?
Well, now that John Jones is back, well, That's interesting because that was a really close fight, that first fight. So that's a fight that I'm really excited about. And at the same time, it's the same card as Chris's card now, isn't it? So we're sharing that one. I think we're going to be the co-main on that one.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I don't know who's the main and who's the co. I don't care as long as my guy wins or gal wins. That's all that matters to me.
Coach, tell everybody where to follow you on social media if they're watching.
Parillo Boxing.
Thank you.
Instagram. Boom.
Make sure to follow and stay tuned right here with Tito Ortiz as he's getting ready for the belt for the third time. Thank you, Coach.